There comes a time, once in your life, when you take the leap, when you go further than you ever thought possible. A time when you make the best decision you will ever make.
And that time is right now, because you can get the Jacksepticeye U2s, the Gaelic Gladiator. He's up for sale right now. Happy St. Patrick's Day. Look at him. Isn't he grand? The big old bell, the big cape, he's ready to do battle. He's even got the little man bun and all. He looks lovely, so he does. Also, the little plushies. Look at my face twice in your face. You can get the plushie with Sam. I'm holding on a little Sam right there. Or you can just get the standing Jacksepticeye plushie. Make him T-pose to assert dominance upon your friends. All three of these are up for sale on YouChoose.com right now. You can check the description to go get yours. And you better act fast. You're going to have to get them today, because once they're sold out, they are gone forever. You're never allowed to see them ever, ever again. So don't you want to see these faces every day? Now's your only chance to do so. Also, did you know that if you buy them, you're actually 10% more Irish? That's just facts and numbers. Hey, how are you? How going? I don't know how to intro a YouTube video, so here we are. Welcome. As many of you know, I've been doing YouTube for quite a while. A good number of years now on the channel. I've been doing videos for, let's see how long. Let's go to my oldest video. 8 years. 8 years ago, I uploaded my Solid Snake impression, which is absolutely infamous. At this point, let's give it a little look-see.
War.
There you go. Over my journey of doing this, I have changed quite a bit. Many different times, I've been many different people throughout those 8 years, as any of us have been. Any of you watching at home, anybody who's been doing it for any length of time, any person in existence ever, over 8 years, you change like twice, maybe three times, I'd imagine. So I had an idea to go back and look at the first videos of some YouTubers, because I've gone back and looked at my old stuff myself a lot. Let's get another sampling of this.
Has changed.
Okay. And I've gone over a bunch of these. Let's see. Let's just look at Devil May Cry, shall we?
Hey, hey. What is going on? My name is Jacksepticeye, and right now I am playing DMC Devil May Cry.
Lord Jesus, the pandemic's gonna be over by the time he gets through that video. Let's go to my first, face cam video. Is it this one? It's the first one that my face is in the thumbnail. Yeah, I bet you know none of you knew I played Amnesia the Dark Descent.
Hello, all you beautiful people out there. My name is Jacksepticeye, and I'm back playing Amnesia the Dark Descent.
Why? My lighting is so terrible! Good holy god! The Blue Yeti microphone with a sock and a pop filter? Look, I'm not gonna lie, this kinda adds an aesthetic. There's something about it, but the frame rate's at 15 FPS.
And if you remember from last
time, I'm in slow motion.
Yeah, cut them rocks.
Not bad, honestly. Not bad for a first face cam video. I'm not as awkward as I thought I would have been.
Hello, all you beautiful people out there. My name is Jacksepticeye, and welcome back to Cry of Fear.
God! Stop it! Kind of cute, though. In an old, nostalgic, cringy sort of way. So, that's my first content. I'm putting that out there to show you that any of the people I look at here today, I'm gonna look at some of my friends' stuff because I haven't actually gone back and looked at a lot of their first videos. Some of them I have, but some people have changed vastly, some of the people that I'm friends with now, so I wanna see what their first content is, but I wanted to put myself out there first to show you that it can't be any worse than that. That is pretty damn bad compared to what I am now. So let's just dig in, shall we? All right, we'll start off with Felix. Because I feel like I've seen his oldest video. Yeah, Minecraft. Minecraft multiplayer fun. That is such a 10 years ago YouTube title as well. You might as well have called it like Minecraft Madness in with my friends or something.
What the fuck is that? my god.
And the fraps.
Yo, yeah.
Is he speaking Swedish?
Ja, så ser jag igen.
Wow.
Han rider Sibien.
Okay, I don't know what the fuck you guys are saying.
All right, welcome back to episode 2.
Wow.
We had some technical issues. I accidentally deleted my hard drive. So we're in a new world, but that's okay.
December 2010. Oh, Lord. Are we supposed to be seeing something in the bottom right? Oh, yeah. That's kind of cool, honestly. No.
360. Oh, that was 720.
Dude, sick!
Oh, wait, the sound is completely off. I forgot that.
Oh, no.
There we go.
This is kind of cool, actually. Like, you can tell it's Felix, but he's just a more subdued version of himself. Because you're putting yourself out there for the first time. You talk a lot more calmly. You just talk normally and you don't want to be too loud. You don't want to blow out your microphone. You don't want to be annoying and obnoxious. It takes years to get to that point. I mean, I was kind of loud in my beginning videos, but then it was much later that I was like, okay, I'm just going to be myself finally. And my accent, I let fly more and I just got louder and louder. But this is really impressive for like a first the first type of videos you're doing, and you're doing a dual let's play? Like, imagine this now, if both of them had face cams in these ones. This would actually be a really great format for a dual let's play.
Indestructible chicken, there you are. That chicken. No, he's our buddy. Aw, you killed him, you motherfucker.
Honestly, it's not that bad. I feel like even today, sure, the production value and the quality, I mean, like, the quality of the mic and everything is not the best, but I feel like stuff like this still exists today, and you see some smaller channels who are making content like this, and it's just so nice to see. You're just chilling, you're playing Minecraft, you're having fun. A+. And then, of course, Amnesia started. I screamed for my mom while playing Amnesia. That is actually a really great 2021 YouTube title. This is the start of it all.
Sorry, whenever I'm so focused and scared shitless, I tend to forget to talk and ramble or whatever. I am sorry about it, but
he cute. So soft spoken. So timid. And then look what he turned into. Lord Jesus! Somebody I'm really interested in is seeing Sykuno's first videos, because I remember seeing some stuff of his old League days. Is any of that actually up on his YouTube channel? Yeah. Corky, Revan back up, full gameplay / commentary. Now, if you're not prepared for what Sykuno's first content was, you're gonna— oh, 74%? Why, dicks? You're gonna have to be— you might get a little whiplash from this.
What is up, guys? It's Sykuno here, and today we are playing as Corky.
That is so different than Sykuno now. Well, it is and it isn't. It's weird to listen to.
As most of you guys know, I was sick for the past week. I do still have a small cough, so if I cough a little bit this game, I'm sorry, but I did want to get... I did want to make a video. I haven't made one in quite a while, and a lot of people messaged me asking me to make more, and I told him I was sick, so here we go, guys.
Here we go, guys. It's me, Sykuno, and I'm here playing League of Legends. Welcome, everybody, to the game. Here's time for a brand new video.
In his defense, all videos around League of Legends or any sort of esport or competitive game like that back then was all exactly like this. If I was into this type of content and I started making it myself, this is exactly how I would have done it. I mean, I spoke in an American accent at the start of my content, because that's like the content I was consuming kind of sounded like that and presented itself that way. So you kind of just take on what other people are doing before you find your own voice and you settle into it. So me and Sykuno's progression from our first videos to our current videos are kind of similar in the fact that they just feel like two completely different people, but you can still hear some of the personality and some of the voice still in there. And then his infamous intro kicked in later. I don't know if it's here.
What is up, guys? It's Sykuno here, and
Yeah, that's the cadence that we got used to. It's Sai Kuno here.
Today we are playing as Ziggs. Let's go ahead and start off with one of these things, one of these, and one of these, and
I have
the mid lane.
Fucking no idea what's happening.
Take a look at the teams here. We have our teleport squad here. We have Nidalee probably up top. We have Leona and Ezreal at the bottom. Zac in the jungle. They have Lee Sin somewhere.
As different as it is, and as much as some of you are probably cringing at it at home, it's okay. Relax your face muscles. We're all here to just have a good time. I feel like if he was to present, if he was to shoutcast some content now, this would be, he has a really great style for that. Like, his voice sounds really good for that. Like, I've been watching some of the Valorant tournaments recently, and it has that exact sound to it. Like, some of the people being like, and here we have Reyna coming down the mid lane, and oh, she's gonna open it up for Jett here, who gets a double. Like, that kind of cadence he has down.
Mordekaiser also somewhere. Jarvan in the jungle and Caitlyn Soraka at the bot lane. Let's go ahead.
I have fucking no idea how to play League of Legends. I have no idea what's happening half the time I watch any of the clips for it. So we're just gonna move on. And then we move on to current Sykuno.
Is we're playing Among Us with the boys is what I heard. I don't know exactly who's in the group. They just told me we're playing Among Us with the boys.
And look, here he is, face cam, calm down, being himself, open, confident, sexy. That's the Sykuno we know and love today.
Is that John? Dang it, there's so many of them.
Such a nice voice. Okay, we gotta check out Corpse's stuff. Because Corpse's voice is also, I mean, everyone's voices change over the years. You get a better mic, it starts to pick up the deeper tones in your voice. Cheap, shitty mics when you start off don't do that. Like, this mic is an incredibly transparent mic. So it picks up my voice exactly as it is, and then you kind of like, you do a little processing on it afterwards, but when you do that in the beginning, you don't do any of that shit. You just don't know how to do it. Yeah, oh. Oh, I used to make thumbnails exactly like this. I know all of these faces that he's used for his thumbnails. I've seen them everywhere. Well, not these ones. This fucking face I have used in a I have done a reading scary stories one. Maybe I should show you that one as well. But this is Corpse's first video.
I've heard of a place out here where I live. It's on one of the back roads of the Alaskan New Growth Forest in one of these valleys.
He still has a deep voice. Not as deep as it is now, for many reasons. Age, the health stuff changes, your vocal cords just change as time goes on, depending on the wear and tear that you have on them. I've definitely fucked up my voice over the years. I can't hit certain notes that I used to be able to do because of all the screaming I used to do playing Happy Wheels. I legitimately damaged my vocal cords doing that, I think. But it made my voice deeper over the years. But you can tell how shitty his mic is now compared to what it is today.
They say that if you drive down this road on a day when the sun is shining so brightly as to make everything appear black and white, then you might come across a girl walking along the side of the road.
It still sounds like Corpse. It still sounds like him. I can tell that it's him. It just doesn't have the like,
hey, what are you guys doing?
Sound to it, you know?
She is always wearing a heavy wool overcoat and a set of oversized headphones, like those big Skullcandy headphones you could find in the stores.
Oh, Skullcandy headphones. They're garbage. Oh. I can find all of your videos. That's it. If I just scroll up a little bit, that's all your videos. What? What the fuck?
It was around 1 year ago.
Oh.
I was 18 and going through the usual trials and tribulations of being an adult. And,
oh.
You know, unemployment, yearning for independence, and figuring out...
That's the voice that we get to know and love. There it is. It's in my head, living rent-free, and that's fine.
What to do with the rest of your life? I handled these by going on walks and clearing my head by following the worn down footpaths of nearby forests and going to bars.
It's, oh, you can see the progression. You can hear the mic quality difference. He's also gotten much better at like acting out the stories. You can tell that before he was just reading it, but now he's actually like living the story, so to speak. He's like drawing you in more. This is far more entertaining to listen to because the music suits, the imagery is better for the story, the way he's presenting it is better. He's just better all around. Deeper voice, better person. And then you have current corpse, which is I'm not playing a single second more of that because it'll get claimed because of it, but the song is fire. I'm actually very curious to hear what Ludwig's first video is. Because the others I've kind of heard before. I haven't actually seen Ludwig's oldest video. MVG Sandstorm Grand Final Power Outage. Okay. You're not hitting this. MVG! MVG! Okay, I want to actually see Ludwig in his first video. Ludwig, where are you? When did you start appearing in your own content?
Why Ludwig Ogren is my favorite Twitch streamer.
This is 2018? Oh my god! This is only... this is like 3 years ago! He's so different! Lud, this should be your first video. This one that you're reacting to. I didn't realize how much of a transformation happened. Like, this looks like... well, this is a year ago. Oh my god. Lud, you fucking popped off in the last few years.
You disgust me.
You disgust me.
I did nothing wrong.
You did everything wrong.
What did I do wrong?
You're the wrong man.
Wow!
I thought that was the whole video.
sneak peek.
I feel like...
That's it. That's all you get. That's all you get. Spend a little bit of time working on that.
Oh my god, he speaks the exact same. And well, I was gonna say he speaks the exact same, but this is only 2018, so of course he would. It's not that long ago. You're basically the same person, but you're not. What's Toast's oldest video? Hearthstone. Makes sense. Huge! Huge! I don't know what's happening. Massive!
Ha, this guy's toast.
Whoa. So he had that even back in 2015.
This is going to be amazing!
Well, his voice changed a lot. He sounded much different back in 2015.
Alright, Mad Bomber. Double hits on Mr. Big Game Hunter.
There he is!
Do it!
Okay, I don't need to understand Hearthstone to know that that was hilarious, so good content. Little did you know that Toast didn't actually show his face in the beginning. He used to wear this actual mask, and that's why it's persisted today. And then eventually he just got confident enough to show himself on camera. Pretty great. Does he have like a face reveal video?
Toast.
That's great.
Starting today, whenever I stream on Twitch, it will be with my normal human face.
Wow.
If people are gonna see what I look like, I'd rather they see it on my own channel than in some random Toast expose video that someone is using just to boost their own channel.
That's true. Yeah. That's something that I know a lot of people who don't show their faces online worry about and have to kind of deal with, that if you don't show yourself, then it's just going to make people hungry for wanting to see your face all the time. I guess it's just human nature and the curiosity to it, but I don't think people realize the stress and strain and anxiety that that puts on the people who don't want to show themselves, that anytime you go out to do anything then, and if people recognize your voice or anything like that, like they can use you just walking around in public and then take pictures of you or at events or anything like that. So it's scary. Some people kind of have to do it under their own power then, that they want to show their face under their own conditions rather than having somebody else do it. I've always kind of had my face out there. In the beginning, I didn't have my face out there for like privacy reasons or anything. I just didn't have a camera to be able to show my face with. And then when I got one, I did, because all the stuff I watched was face cam content. So I can't imagine what it's like to live like that, worrying all the time about people wanting to see your face. So please just respect people's privacy when it comes to these things and just allow them to be
faceless if they want to remain faceless. He went from not showing his face to showing his ass on Twitter. Our times have changed. That's what we call character progression and confidence and growth, and we love to see it. What was Charlie's first video? I'm an OG Charlie fan. Well, not from like the very, very first videos, but definitely around the beginning. Like, I think I started watching him like 9 years ago. Because I've been doing it for 8, and I've definitely been watching Charlie for like a year plus. God damn. Gears of War jetpack glitch. 10 years ago. So I imagine his... So he's not in these videos. YouTube was a very different landscape. 13 years ago. Holy shit, maybe I'm not an OG. Holy fuck. Charlie has been doing it forever. Much longer than I assumed.
Hey, what's up everybody, it's Critical. I'm starting a new video series for Battlefield Bad Company 2 called Battlefield Bad Company 2 Fun Tactics. This is episode 1 called Sniper the New Shotgun. All right, now the way this works is you're going to want...
God damn, I can feel the testosterone already. God, he sounds a lot different, but he also has the same sort of like talking and cadence and tone. Again, mic quality does a lot for that.
Make the assault class have the primary be any shotgun, secondary any secondary, specialization 1, slugs, second specialization, magnum ammo, and third...
It's just such a normal video. Like, of the time... This is just a really good video. Why does my content back in the day have to be fucking awful? I mean, he hasn't talked about dick tips or titties at all in the minute that I've been watching, so I guess that's kind of cringe.
What's up, everybody? It's Critical.
Oh, the classic.
What's up, everybody? It's Critical.
Oh, I remember those days. I would sit down and binge so many of his videos back to back every night. I guess I haven't been watching it as long as I thought I did. Maybe like 9 years ago. I think I've been watching him slightly before I started. And I remember he already had like such a back catalog of me to go back and watch through. And I used to love it. It was such like comfort viewing.
This is another video for Fallout New Vegas. This time I'm going to show you all the locations to the 4 best weapons in the game. I was originally going to do a video for all the unique weapons in the game.
So he just did tactics videos. Pepsi Man gameplay and commentary, 9 years ago. This must be like prime time fucking Leet Fingies Charlie.
What's up everybody, it's Critical. I'm playing Pepsi Man for the PlayStation 1. Now this game was only released in Japan.
It just sounds like Charlie.
I won't be able to read the dialogue that really brings out the best in this game.
Charlie's always just been himself. This is 2012. Oh God, yeah, the Mighty Thirsty and the Smart Mop. These were when I came in, so 8 years ago. Fridge Locker, 8 years ago, yeah. I started watching these. And these were the first videos I saw of Charlie. Everyone saw these videos back then. These were like the viral things of the time. And then you went back, I just went back and watched all his older stuff. But he's always just been the same, but back then he never showed his face. And I remember thinking back in the day, like, I wonder what he looks like. And it took years and years and years of his content before he actually ever showed his face. And I remember seeing him for the first time and thinking, oh no, he has it all. Not only is he hilarious, he's got a great fucking voice. He's the sex master testosterone god. But he's handsome as well? He's got it all, baby! Fucking Charlie, man. Professor Sad.
Professor Sad, the world's most depressed instructor.
I fucking love Charlie's content. I've been watching for so long. Been such a fan for so many years. And it's so cool to be able to call him a friend at this point. What a man. Wait, I want to actually look at Evelyn's first video. Fatal Frame 5 Let's Play is on its way.
Hi guys, what's up? My name's Evelyn and I'm from the Netherlands, but I live in Japan.
Wow!
And I'm a big horror fan and I've played all the games and watched all the movies. And one of my favorite series is Fatal Frame, or where in Europe it's called Project Zero.
Wow, face cam! Not only a face cam for your first video, but just full face cam, like a vlog, as your first video. That's ballsy. I didn't even do that. I don't know if I would have done this. I don't know if I would have had the bravery to do this immediately.
It didn't come out in the rest of the world. I think they had some translation issues, that it was too expensive, and they canceled the project, if I'm correct.
It's so weird, because she looks and sounds so much like she does now, but she has such a heavier Dutch accent back here.
That sucked. So from part 4 on, I started playing it in Japanese because I studied Japanese and... but it was very hard at the time. I
can hear how nervous she is though, like having to talk on camera. It's like, okay, take your time, say things right. I wonder how many times it took her to do this as well. This is a very unfortunate face to stop on. Evelyn, I'm so sorry. She kicked in my door, punched me in the back of the head. When was this? 6 years ago.
Hi.
Hi. Yeah, 27th, 2014. So just after her birthday. Damn.
On Twitter, Operation Zero, starting and ending with the number zero, asked me if the game had English subs, so that's the first thing I checked. So, at options...
This is great!
I can only see rocks in the darkness.
This is always so impressive to me as well, whenever she does this. Like, she can do a whole game in Japanese and just read it and understand it and be fluent in it. It's phenomenal. I remember when we first met, I was like, so can you like watch anime without the subtitles? Such a cringy thing to ask. She was like, yeah, I have a master's degree in Japanese. It's like, it's like being like, can you understand Irish people when you go back home?
Now what?
Such chill content. I'm over here being like, hello, all you beautiful people out there. My name is Jacksepticeye and welcome back to Cry of Fear. What the fuck am I doing, man? Let's skip ahead a bit and go to this one.
Hey guys, welcome back. What was I doing? I think.
More confident. Better camera, or at least better like lighting. Sounds like a better microphone.
I have no. Oh yeah. Wait. Oh, okay, there are my items. Check the map.
Now she sounds so much like she does today.
Remains. Okay.
Now she just sounds like she does today.
How about living for Susan?
I lied. I always lie.
I always lie. So take that one and then go to newest.
Hey everyone, welcome back to another episode of Twilight Princess.
The confidence, the glow up, the the beauty. A shit ton of tattoos as well, which are so fucking cool. Tattoos are badass. Anyway, excuse me as I gush over my girlfriend for a bit, but we're here to listen to the content.
Oh, they tried. Oh my god.
Much better camera. Much better microphone. Much more confidence. I've never played Twilight Princess. I think I played like the first hour of it. And then nothing else.
Ah, oh, he's so cool.
Thank you. Even though I've never played Twilight Princess. You're cool. God, I've been recording for so long. But there are other people that I want to see. I want to look at Ray's first. Let's go back to the very first one. Stream highlights. Okay, 3 years ago. Whoa. 3 years ago? I keep hoping to like, I can dig way back and people are uploading like college graduation or high school or something. But this is like, 3 years ago is not that long ago.
Oh, wait, you gotta like fix them so they're not crazy.
Rawr, XD.
Oh no.
Oh man. God. Still Ray. Fuck yeah, get him. Okay. Wow. All those people that I'm watching before to now, even if it's subtle, there's like a confidence to them now. There's a, I guess a lot of that comes with age. You kind of settle into who you are. And if you're doing this job for a while and you've been on camera for a while, you get very comfortable at looking at yourself because you have to stream or you have to record. And in my case, I was editing so much of myself. So you see so much of your face. So much of your mannerisms and your voice and everything that you get so used to it after a while that confidence sort of comes from that. It was a great kind of tool for me to come out of my shell a bit more and get a bit better at interacting with other people. Oh, remember Fortnite? Remember when people played Fortnite? Even I played Fortnite. Should I say Fortnite more? Will that get the video into search rankings better? Fortnite, Fortnite, Fortnite. Nice. Nice. Nice! Get him!
Yes! Oh my gosh!
She's banging her head on the table.
Yes! Oh my gosh!
Okay, this is going to be a big one. 5 years ago. Oh, it's a different channel though. I forgot. You are 9 in this video. You're like fucking 10 years old. What is happening? This is not long enough ago.
What is up, my cricket crew? It's the Cricket Blades, and today we are playing Until Dawn. Now, I know that this was in the voting thing for voting for the next Let's Play.
This is still quite a while ago. This is still different than current Ethan, of course. But, I mean, come on. This is what I was hoping for going back to watch people's first videos. I want to see people in their infancy. I don't have any videos like this back then. I love that he's like smiling during the whole thing. Oh my god! You didn't even understand those lyrics in that video. Wait, I want to ask him. Oh, hi Spencer!
Hi Josie, hi!
Good ol' Sean.
I'm recording a video right now.
Oh, great.
I think I was 10 or 11. I look like I'm 6.
I said you looked like you were 9 years old, and then I said you were 10, so I got it right.
Yeah.
My god.
Yes. Terrible. Do you want me to send you my first video? It's unlisted.
Yes, I would love to. Okay. Do you mind me showing it?
Yeah, that's fine. It's awful.
Okay, I would love that.
It's so bad.
Okay, please send it to me.
Alright.
Okay, bye. Oh, that's exciting. What is this? Dirty Mike and the Boys Happy Wheels gameplay numero uno. Ethan, your first ever video was Happy Wheels?
So we're gonna play some Happy Wheels today. I'm Ethan.
Oh god.
Alright. Alright.
This is what I wanted. This is the cringe that I wanted.
Dude, Joe's.
Play count.
Joe's.
Alright, let's do this. This is like
a. Who is this guy and why does he not want to be in the video?
Ooh, she's a rough one.
Frame rate.
Stop, kid. I like how we have no damage done to us, separate Timmy's arms.
They've been watching for like 30 seconds of you just like, come on, I can't get it.
Wow, it's hard, okay? Happy Wheels, one of the hardest games known to man. I should know, it took us 100 episodes to finally beat it, but we beat Happy Wheels. We got to the end of it and we won. We got the trophy at the end of Happy Wheels. Feels real good. This is cute though.
We need to show them my reaction to the, Annie Oni.
Cause this is just two, like, two young guys hanging out. Just guys being dudes! Hanging out just on an afternoon. And they're like, you know what? YouTube's a thing. Let's record a YouTube video. This is uploaded in 2017, but obviously this is a lot longer ago.
Thing or the Oni.
They already ended. So anyway, the comment section below, I'll say what, PS3 games I have, so you can...
In the description, you mean.
Yeah, in the description, I'll say that. And he'll say what Xbox games you have.
It reminds me of watching, like, old Smosh stuff. You know, the Mortal Kombat video they did in their bedroom? It kind of has that vibe to it. That's an absolute glow-up if I've ever seen one. That's probably the biggest glow-up in this video, is older or younger Ethan to current Ethan. He says he's 15 in this video. Wow, because the other one, the Fergalicious one, isn't like a YouTube upload. He wasn't uploading videos on YouTube at that age. It was a video that was like a home video that was recorded that he later showed to people on YouTube. But this is like his first YouTube actual video to be like, I'm being YouTuber. 15. Good Jesus. I was 22 when I uploaded my first one. I was about to turn 23. So it was like 4 months before I turned 23. So, what's wild is that I started my channel just before Ethan's current age. And actually, so many of my other friends' ages. And it's crazy to see that, like, now you have someone like Tommy Innit who's uploading content. And he's 16. And he's, like, the biggest thing in the past year on Twitch. That's fucking wild. so many people are getting so big so quickly at such young ages that I hope you're all taking care of yourselves, first of all. Because that's a lot of pressure to put on you at such a young age that I couldn't even handle it at, like, 24. I was 24 when the channel hit 1 million subscribers, so... Man, so many people are starting YouTube so young now. At 16, I just got the internet in my house. So, that'll tell you a lot about, like, the trajectory now of some people compared to back then. In the earlier days of YouTube. I feel old. Anyway, this video's been going on for ages, so I'm gonna leave it there. There's plenty of other people that I could look at. Maybe we'll do a second update to this, and you guys can leave suggestions down in the comments of who to look at, and if anybody had, like, huge changes, between their earlier videos and now. So, that was interesting to watch, though, to see how people... It's fascinating how some people went from, like, being them to being... just better at entertaining, but still being them. And then other people went from, like, really young and no confidence at all to much older and much more confident and mature and much better at presenting themselves. The growth is different for everybody, but everybody has to start somewhere and everyone has to start with a certain setup and a certain video. It's easy to look at everybody doing it now and be like, oh, you started there and you had, like, great equipment the entire time. And then you look back at the older videos, like, no, we started nowhere. I started in a log cabin with no face cam. The webcam we had recorded at 15 FPS, and I used that as my microphone in my collar. And that was it. And I had a crappy PC that had, like, a 560 in it back in the day. So, just start with whatever you have. And keep growing and keep making content and you'll get there eventually. It's a harsh business, but everyone starts somewhere. Everyone starts from zero, but hopefully this was at least interesting to watch. I just wanted to do it in general, so I thought I might as well record it anyway. But if you liked it, don't forget to like the video and don't forget to subscribe. All that stuff. Whatever. You're used to it by now. We've been doing it for 8 years. Nothing really changed. But yeah, I'll see you in the next one.